This video tutorial I will explain how to generate the WAR file and deploy the web service application on Tomcat server which is installed in EC2 instance. Before generating the WAR file, we have to make some changes. The first change is the class application should extends Spring Boot servlet initializer, and it should override this configure method, and it should return builder.sources. Then in pom.xml file, the packaging we have to specify as var. By default, packaging is jar. That we have to change it to var. And also, we have to include Spring Boot starter Tomcat dependency. And scope should be provided. And this is to instruct Spring Boot not to use the inbuilt Tomcat server. Here you can see the class application, which is Spring Boot application, and it extends Spring Boot servlet initializer and override configure method. And in pom.xml file, packaging we have specified as var, and also we have included Spring Boot starter Tomcat dependency. Then use this Maven command to generate the WAR file. MVN clean install, and then I am skipping the JUnit test cases. Here you can see build is successful and WAR file is generated in this location. Click on refresh. And here you can see the WAR file has been generated. Here you can see the application.properties file, and here you can see the context path name user-app-ws. This context path name and WAR file name should be same before we deploy the WAR file in the external Tomcat server. Rename that. Here you can see the database URL. In that we have mentioned the database name as org_db. So we have to create this database first. And to connect to the database, we are using root as username and password as root. And here is the driver class name. Now we will create the database as org_db. Here you can see Amazon AWS console, and in that I have started this particular EC2 instance. Copy this IPv4 address. And I have connected to EC2 server. Using this command, start the MariaDB server. And using this command, I am going to log into MariaDB. And it is showing access denied for user root at localhost. Use this command mysql -u, username is root, -p, the password is also root, and it is successfully connected. And these many databases are there. use create database command to create org underscore db database. And it is successfully created. We can check that. And here you can see org underscore db is created. Next, I am going to start the Tomcat server. And here you can see the Tomcat server has been started. Copy this DNS name. And Tomcat is running on 8080 port. And Tomcat web page has been opened. Click on Manager app. Click on Choose File to deploy the WAR file. And inside the target folder, the WAR file is there, which we have generated. Click on Deploy. And here you can see the WAR file has been placed inside web apps folder, and it is deploying this WAR file. And here you can see the WAR file has been deployed successfully, and it is running. And if you want to stop or reload or undeploy, you can use these options. Click on Logs. And here you can see the WAR file has been successfully deployed. When I was clicking Manager app, it was not asking username and password, because I already entered username and password when I have tested. I am removing the browser history. Refresh. Click on Manager app, and here you can see now it is asking username and password. Username is admin and password is admin123, which I already configured. And it has logged in successfully. Now I am going to check in org underscore db, the tables are created. And you can see users table and addresses table and hibernate underscore sequence table has been created based on the domain objects. Here you can see user entity class. And based on that, this users table is created. And here you can see address entity class. Based on that, addresses table is created, which will have these columns. And users table will have these columns: ID, user ID, first name, last name, email, encrypted password, etc. And currently the users table does not have any record, and addresses table also does not have any record. And users table has columns like ID, email, email verification status, email verification token, encrypted password, first name, last name, and user ID. And addresses table has ID, address underscore ID, city, country, postal code, street name, type, and user ID. These columns are automatically created based on these entity classes. Now we will see how to send a HTTP request to a web service which is deployed on the remote EC2 server. Here you can see the Tomcat server is up and running, and the web service application is deployed and it is successfully running. Now we will see how to send request using Postman and create the user, get the user, etc. To create the user, we have to use this URL, and in that, instead of localhost, we have to provide a DNS name, and HTTP method should be post, and in the body, we have to provide this JSON. It has user details like first name, last name, email address, password, and addresses. HTTP method should be post, and copy this DNS name. Instead of localhost, it should be DNS name. And port number is 8080. Click on body. Select JSON. Click on headers. And here you can see the content type is JSON, which we are going to send to the server. And the response can be XML or JSON. So if you want to specifically JSON, you can mention here. Click on send. And here you can see, we got status code as 200 OK, and the user is successfully created, and we got public user ID as this value. And here you can see the user table has one record. And here you can see the addresses table has two records. Next, we will send request to this login URL to get public user ID and JWT token. And for this particular request, HTTP method should be post, and in the body, we have to pass email address and the password. And here is the request URL. Copy the DNS name. Instead of localhost, it should be DNS name. And in the body, we provided email address and password. Click on send. We got status code as 200 OK, so it is successful. Click on headers. And here we got public user ID, and here we got the JWT token. Next, we will see how to get the user details using public user ID. For that, we have to use this URL, and HTTP method should be get. And here you can see we are using this URL to get the user details, and HTTP method should be get. And public user ID, copy from here. And in the headers, we have to pass JWT token. So here you can see authorization. If it is not there, you have to add that. And copy this JWT token. Click on send. So it could not send the request because here localhost is there. We have to put the DNS name. Click on send. And here we got the user details based on the public user ID we have sent. If you want to access Swagger UI web page, then we have to use this URL, and this is the DNS name we have to provide, and at the end swagger-ui.html should be there. Open link in the new tab, and here provide swagger-ui.html. Click on enter, and here we got the Swagger page, and it has API documentation for the user web service application. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.